I'm Michele Warmund, Fruit Extension Specialist at the University of Missouri. I'd like to talk about how American elderberry plants are pollinated and what you can do to improve the amount of fruit produced by these plants. American elderberry plants produce flowers in clusters called umbels. Each year, umbels consisting of 2,000 or more small flowers are produced. In June, elderberry flowers are primarily wind pollinated. However, insects also transport pollen from flowers on one plant to those on other plants, even though they are of minor importance in pollinating large numbers of flowers. Flowers of cultivars commonly grown in Missouri are considered self-infertile, which means that cross-pollination is needed to produce a good crop of fruit. Thus, to achieve cross-pollination and produce high fruit yield, pollen from one cultivar is needed to fertilize flowers of a different cultivar. At the University of Missouri, we studied how pollination occurs in elderberry using various cultivars, including Pocahontas and Bob Gordon. First, we transferred Pocahontas pollen onto the female part of a Bob Gordon flower, known as a stigma. After 24 hours, you can see by the blue staining where the transferred pollen germinated and produced tubes that grew down through the styles of the flowers and into the ovules in the ovary. This type of pollen tube growth indicates that fertilization can occur with subsequent fruit development. A similar situation occurred when Bob Gordon pollen was placed on a Pocahontas stigma. In another experiment, Pocahontas pollen was transferred to a Pocahontas stigma, and pollen tube growth was examined every 24 hours, up to 120 hours. From 24 to 72 hours, you can see from the blue staining in this flower that pollen tubes grew but never reached the ovules. However, at 96 hours after transferring Pocahontas pollen to another Pocahontas flower, only a few pollen tubes reached the ovules. This result explains how a small number of berries can form on an isolated plant or plants that are self-pollinated. These results are important when planting American elderberry. To produce the most fruit, plant at least two different cultivars that have overlapping bloom periods. For just a few plants, group them together at about 4 to 10 feet apart. For large-scale plantings, single rows of different cultivars planted adjacent to each other will facilitate pollination and maximize fruit production. In Missouri, several American elderberry cultivars have overlapping bloom periods. For example, Bob Gordon and Pocahontas have synchronous bloom periods. These cultivars also produce high fruit yields and are recommended for planting. Although there are other cultivars that have overlapping bloom, they have not performed as well as Bob Gordon and Pocahontas in research trials. A few other practices can enhance pollination. If you have just a few plants, an umbel can be cut from one flower, turned upside down, and used to dust or shake pollen onto flowers of another cultivar. If good pollination does not commonly occur in an established large-scale planting, any practice that promotes pollen movement through the air onto flowers of a different cultivar can improve pollination. It may be possible to use a fan to blow pollen across rows of plants to enhance pollination with an air blast sprayer or a drone. Also, in cases where plants do not bloom simultaneously, pollen can be collected and frozen to dust later flowering umbels of another cultivar. We do not find it necessary to try the pollen before cold storage. There are several online sites that demonstrate how to collect and store pollen. Currently, there are no commercial sources for purchasing pollen, but this may be possible in the future. In conclusion, the best way to promote the development of a bountiful fruit crop is to select and plant two or more different elderberry cultivars with overlapping bloom periods.